ॐ दक्षिणास्य समारम्भा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ता स्मर्या गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः परिज्ञानाश्रम श्री गुरु शंकर परिज्ञानाश्रम शंकर सद्गुरु केशववामन कृष्ण पांडुरंग आनंद परिज्ञान गुरु सद्योजात शंकर सद्गुरु गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यङ्करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्बत्वा मनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः। अर्जुना इज नाउ टोटली एफ्लिक्टेड बाय हिज संसारा एंड एज आई सेड लास्ट टाइम हिज संसारा इज नथिंग बट रागा और एक्सट्रीम अटैचमेंट और इमोशनल डिपेंडेंस ऑन हिज स्वजना दैट इज हिज पीपल हुम ही थिंग्स आर हिज ओन दैट इज एस्पेशली भीष्मा एंड द्रोणा आर द पीपल ही इज वेरी मच अटैच टू भीष्म द्रोणा एंड दैट रागा इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू शोका बिकॉज ही नोज दैट वॉट एवर ही इज गोइंग टू डू नाउ इज समथिंग विच इज गोइंग टू हार्म दोज पीपल And what he says or what his thought process is justified. Justified because on both the sides are his swajanas. There are people belong to his own clan on both the sides. And because of this, it is going to be a damage caused to his own people on both the sides. And he's overcome by compassion. But unfortunately, his compassion and his train of thoughts is not yogya for that particular time and for that particular context. Compassion is okay, but when compassion becomes out of place and out of time, it can become something like, you know, diffidence. So now slowly, what is happening to Arjuna is when he sees the consequences of his action, he's slowly developing diffidence and he feels that I should not go ahead with this. And he even says that Dhartarashtran Hantum Vayam Na Arhaha. We are not really even capable or arha or qualified to even destroy an Atatayin like Duryodhana. That means it just shows how his thinking is completely affected by his moha, Raga Shoka Moha. And what is this moha causing him? He's seeing Dharma Yuddha as Adharma. He's seeing that this Dharma that he has to follow in this particular situation is Adharma. and he is trying to escape from that, which is Palayana. So Palayana is also Adharma, and seeing the Dharma Yuddha as Adharma is also, you know, his confusion. So what he is caught up with is this confusion, and in this confusion, he has already made up his mind that he is not going to fight this war. And to substantiate that, he is going to keep on giving any number of reasons. And all these reasons are nothing more than excuses. See, it happens that when you are in confusion and when you have decided to do something, whether it's right or wrong, you want to justify yourself and you want to present your case. So what Arjuna is doing now is presenting his case as to why they should not fight this war. And he brought so many reasons, initially starting with his physical manifestations, and also he started telling Krishna how adharmic it is to fight this war. Now, in the next few verses, till the end of this chapter, Arjuna is going to take the sociological impacts, the impacts on the society, the impacts on dharma, the impacts on Varna Ashrama, all these things he's going to take. Yes, in some other context, whatever Arjuna is thinking, you know, is a very mature way of thinking. But here, he's trying to convince himself and convince Krishna that this is the reason for which I am not willing to go ahead with this war. And now he brings about what is going to happen at a large scale in the society if this war is fought. So we'll go to the 39th verse, and in the 39th verse he says, katham nagneyam asmabhihi papadasmat nivartitum kulakshaya kritam dosham prapashyadbhir janardana. So hey Janardana, even though we are seeing this as kulakshaya, he already said in the previous verse that we'll be destroying the clan itself. We'll be destroying the families. We'll be destroying the heads of the families. Thousands of people are going to die, and you know, all their families are going to be without any people who are going to support these families. And it is said that fathers and grandfathers, uncles, the elders in the household, they are like gurus, and they are the ones who are going to make the younger generation imbibe the culture, imbibe the values. And it is said that these people are the dharmis who follow dharma. If one wants to protect dharma, one has to protect the dharmi, the one who is following dharma. And here what is going to happen in this kind of a mass destruction, all the dharmis or those who are, you know, upholding the dharma and giving the values of dharma and culture to the entire family, those people themselves will not be there. In that case, what will happen to the kulas? What will happen to the families and the family dharmas? And so he's saying here, kulakshayam dosham prapashyat bhihi he Janardana. Even though we are able to see what the doshas of this kulakshaya that we are going to do, it is such a papa. Papad asmat nivartitum katham nagneyam asmabhihi. Why can't we back out? Why can't we withdraw from this papa? No, it's a papa. I'm seeing it as a papa. And I'm going to tell you what are the consequences of such a papa. Now, even here, Krishna is not talking anything. He's letting Arjuna vent out his case. He's allowed to present his case. And now Arjuna is going to talk about, you know, he has a full cause-effect chain of what will happen if there is a kulakshaya. Yes, he's right. But then the way he portrays it, it's only to support his decision of withdrawing from the war. Now he says in the 40th verse, what will happen if there is a kulakshaya? What will happen if there is a clan itself gets completely destroyed? The social structure of the society gets destroyed. All the earning members, the people who are supporters of the family, most of the men who are going to get killed, then what remains? What happens? So he says here, kulakshaye pranashyanti कुलधर्मा सनातना धर्मे नष्टे कुलं कृत्स्नम अधर्मो अभिभत्युता. सो ही सेज, अर्जुना सेज, व्हेन कुलक्षया हैपन्स, व्हाट हैपन्स? द कुल धर्माज ऑल्सो गो. सी एवरी क्लैन, एवरी फैमिली, एवरी कुला हैज इट्स ओन धर्माज. वी हैव ऑल सीन दैट देर इज अ वर्ण धर्म, देर इज एन आश्रम धर्म, देर इज अ धर्म ऑफ दैट पर्टिक्युलर काला एंड देशा इन दैट पर्टिक्युलर रीजन. एंड वी ऑल्सो नो दैट एवरी फैमिली, एवरी कुला ऑल्सो हैव देर ओन धर्म. देर इज अ कुल धर्म, देन देर इज अ वर्ण धर्म, आश्रम धर्म, देश धर्म, राज्य धर्म, काल धर्म, देर आर सामान्य धर्मास, देर आर विशेष धर्मास. नाउ दोज हु आर गोइंग टू फॉलो दिस धर्म देमसेल्व्स आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्जॉइंट. देन वॉट हैपन्स? दैट कुल धर्म विच हैज कम फ्रॉम टाइम इमेमोरियल, विच हैज बीन फ्लोइंग डाउन सनातन ऑल द टाइम, विच हैज बीन कमिंग डाउन, passed on from one generation to one generation in the kula, that dharma is going to get nashta. And dharme nashte kulam kritsnam adharmaha abhibhatyuta. That means this entire, you know, kula is going to really get into a mode of adharma. Because they do not know. They do not know what is really the dharma. There's nobody to instill this and make the kula follow this dharma. And then what will happen? If the kula dharma is lost, what will happen? Adharma abhibhavat krishna pradushyanti kulastriyaha strishu dushta suvarshneya jayate varna sankaraha. Now with the kula dharmas gone, the varna dharma will also be gone. And when the main breadwinner of the family, the leader of the family, the main person of the family is gone, then the whole responsibility falls on the stri, kula stri, to take on or continue. And in such a situation, in such a helpless situation, the kula stris may be given to wrong ways of living. He says, pradushyanti kula striyaha. The kulastriyaha or the women of these families, you know, since they are not capable of supporting the family, they may take to untoward or wrong ways of living just to support the family. And when such a thing happens, what happens? Jayate varna sankaraha. Varna sankaraha means there will be a mixing up of the varnas. Varnas means here we have Brahmana, then Kshatriya, Vaishya, Kshudra. They are not jatis, they are not castes, they are varnas. They are groups made depending upon what kind of a work they are good at and what kind of a guna or what kind of a mind they have to do a particular kind of a karma. And therefore, the varna dharmas will go. There may not be a varna persisting at all because the kulastris, you know, may get married to other varnas. And then, you know, the progeny born out of these will not have any kind of a dharma. There'll be a mixing up of varnas, and so varna sankara will take place. Varna sankara, when it takes place, of course, in today's world, varna sankara has already happened. You know, there is varna, nobody knows actually, you know, which varna we belong to. There has been a mixing up and sankara. But in those days, in the Vaidika days, varna sankara was considered to be a very, very negative, you know, step or a very negative thing for the family, for the entire society to happen. So there will be jayate varna sankaraha. I'm going very fast in these verses because I just want to say what is Arjuna's thought process here. And he's now seeing at a larger picture of such a vast destruction, a destruction of such a scale, how it can have impact on the breaking down of the entire society. So in the next verse, in the 42nd verse, he says, Sankaro narakayaiva kulagnanam kulasya cha patanti pitaro hyesham lupta pindodaka kriyaha. One of the varna dharmas is varna ashrama dharmas, especially varna dharmas, is to do Shraddha Karma to the departed, to their ancestors, doing shastra, you know, this giving what is called as pinda and udaka, you know, doing this shraddha karma to the departed souls is something very important. Varna dharma, in all the varna dharmas they are there. But when there is a varna sankara, then the progeny of that varna sankara, which kula or which varnas, you know, ancestors, they are going to offer this pidda and udaka. So even the shraddha samskaras are going to suffer because of the varna sankara. And when it is said in the shastras that when the karmas for the pitrus, shraddha karmas, are not done, it is pitru runa, it is the runa of every one of us, every varna, to show the pitru runa by doing this shraddha karmas. And when that does not happen, what will happen to the pitrus who are depending upon this? It is said that the pitrus are waiting for the shraddha karma to be done by their descendants, and they will be patanti pitaro hesham. The pitrus also will fall down. And also this means that this entire clan with varna sankara, they are not doing the right things they are supposed to do, and that may actually give them a naraka prapti. See, there was a concept of swarga and naraka. Naraka here means, you know, a world of dukkha, a world of sorrow. So they'll probably, even after death, they will enter a world of dukkha, kashta, and sorrow. Next, he goes to the same. He's describing this Varna Sankara. In the 43rd verse, he says, Doshai yetai kulagnanam Varna Sankara karakaihi उत्साद्यन्ते जाति धर्माः कुल धर्माश्च शाश्वताः. सो कुलघ्नानाम, फॉर अस हु हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड द कुलास, वी हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड द एंटायर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सोसाइटी, एंड वर्ण संकर कारकैः, दोज ऑफ अस हु हैव डिस्ट्रॉयड द वर्णास एंड वी हैव क्रिएटेड द वर्ण संकरास, these are the doshas. What are we doing? Utsadyante jati dharmaha kula dharmascha shashvata. The jati dharmas, the kula dharmas, the varna dharmas, ashrama dharmas. Dharma means what? The right way of living. That's all. Dharma means each kula, each varna has been given a way of living or a way of life, which is called the right way of living. And utsadyante, nobody will follow the right way of living which is pertaining to that particular kula and dharma. So all the shashvata dharmas are destroyed, and we will be the cause for this kind of a disorder in the society. Then utsanna kula dharmanam manushyanam janardhana नरके नियतं वासः भवति इत्यनुशुश्रुमा. नाउ अर्जुन सेज उत्सन्न कुल धर्माणां, बाय इरेडिकेटिंग और रिमूविंग दिस कुल धर्मास बाय द रूट्स, बाय यू नो ऑफ पीपल, वी पीपल हु आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सच अ थिंग, व्हाट विल हैपन टू अस? नरके नियतं वासः, all of us are definitely, you know, going to be, you know, find a place in Naraka or the world of Dukkha later on. And then he says, bhavati iti narake niyatam vasaha bhavati iti anu shushruma. I have heard it. Now he is trying to take the support of the Shruti. He is trying to take the support of Vedas. See, for a drowning man, he tries to take the support of anything that is available to him. Now, Arjuna wants to convince Krishna, as if Krishna is not aware of it. He wants to convince Krishna and tell him that, look, we people are doing this papa, and certainly we'll be reserved a place in the Narakam. And I have heard about it from our, you know, from our Purvajas. And it is also there in the Vedas. I have heard about it. Iti anushushruma. So Krishna, I am not telling this on my own. Okay, I am just repeating whatever the Vedas have talked to us about. And then, Aho bata maha mahat papam kartum vyavasita vayam yadrajya sukhalobhena hantum swajana mudyataha. Aho bata, alas, oh my God, alas. You know, fie on me, we say. There is another term used, fie on us. You know, aho bataha. Mahat papam kartum vyavasita vayam. We are about to do a very, very grave papa. Mahat papam kartum vyavasita vayam. Very great papa we are about to do. And why are we doing it? Yad rajya sukha lobhena. For the lobha or the greed of rajya and sukha. Actually speaking, Pandavas are not after Raja Lobha or Sukha Lobha. They have tried their best to give, to get whatever is their due. And since they have been denied whatever is their due, they are trying to fight this Dharma Yuddha. And see, all these things are not felt by the opposite army. You know, all these things that we will be responsible for Kulakshaya. Kulakshaya will give rise to all Varna Sankara, Dharma Sankara. All these things are only being thought of by Arjuna. But such a thing is not thought of by the other party at all. Because they are still following Adharma. And ultimately the function or ultimately the duty of a Kshatriya like Arjuna Pandavas, who have always sided Dharma, is to see that Adharma is removed. Yes, there are going to be prizes, price paid. Both sides are going to pay the price for it. And whatever Arjuna has talked about, yes, it is bound to happen. But the thing is, it does not mean that this has to prevent the Pandavas or Arjuna from fighting this war. So, hantum swajana mudyataha. We are almost ready to kill our own people, rajya sukha lobhena. But that is not true. He is too harsh on himself. Arjuna is too harsh on himself. And Krishna also doesn't talk anything. He just allows him to put out all his frustration and feelings and diffidence. And then next he says, Yadi mama pratikaram ashastram shastra panayaha dharta rashtrarane hanyoho tanme kshemataram bhavet. So, hey Krishna, if yadi mam apratikaram, I am not going to fight back. Apratikara. Pratikara means I have to fight them back. They'll fight me back. I have to fight them back. So yadi mam apratikaram, I do not fight. I do not return their arrows. And ashastram, I will give up all my shastras and astras. Then what will happen? Shastra panayaha dhartarashtraha. These dhartarashtras who are having the weapons, they are not going to give up the weapons. They are waiting for this pratikara. So dhartarashtra shastra panaya, that what are they going to do? The shastra pranayaha, shastra panayaha dhartarashtra. They will kill me. Rane hanyum tanme kshemataram bhavet. I know they'll kill me. They will kill all of us. But I think it is better. It is better that I get killed rather than kill them. I am not going to fight back and I am going to give up my arms and I am going to be standing here. Let the war start. Let them come and let them, you know, destroy me. And it is better I die than kill others. This was his, you know, final thing where he has, you know, almost at present lost all his arguments, given up, presented his face, and he is now feeling that extreme helplessness. As I said initially, a warrior or a yodha Arjuna went to the stage of realizing his samsara and expressed his samsara verbally, physically, in every way. Now the time has come for Arjuna to really see the helplessness of his samsara. It is only when one feels the helplessness of one's samsara, then he or she asks for help. So with this, the first chapter is over. where Sanjaya now is reporting to Dhritarashtra and he says, Yeva muktva Arjuna sankhe rathopastha upavishat visrijya sasharam chapam shokasam vigna manasaha. Now this Arjuna, thus Arjuna spoke for all this time in the battlefield sankhe, and now what is he doing? Visrijya sasharam chapam. He just discarded or kept aside his dhanus and his arrows. And what was he a picture of? Shoka samvigna manasaha. He was a picture of despair and sorrow. And what did he do? He did not have the strength to even stand there. So what did he do? Rathopastham upavishat. He sat down. He sat on the ratha, where he was standing ready to fight, ready to go, raring to go. He suddenly felt that he could not do it and he just sat down, giving up, putting his shara and chapa, shara chapam means a sharam chapam, means his entire, whatever arms he had, he just put them on the ratha and he sat down on the ratha. Now, his vishada continues in the next chapter also, in the second chapter also, for about 10 verses. But then Vyasa finds that at this stage he should break this chapter and give a sangati of this chapter to the next chapter. Sangati means a connection. Therefore, a few verses of Arjuna Vishada he still leaves to be covered in the first 5 or 6 verses of the second chapter. And how does it end? Every chapter ends with this. Om Tat Sat Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gita Su Upanishatsu Brahma Vidyayam Yoga Shastre Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade Arjuna Vishada Yogo Nama Prathamodhyayah. Now I said last time, what is this yoga? Every chapter in Bhagavad Gita is called as yoga. Now, what is the meaning of yoga? There are many, many, many meanings of yoga. But the most important, relevant meaning here is yoga means that which connects, that which gives sangati. Now, what he says is Arjuna Vishada Yogo Nama Pratama Adhyaya. Now, this Adhyaya brings us in connection with the subject matter of the chapter called Arjuna Vishada. So what is revealed in this, that is connected. I, the reader, get connected to the subject matter which is revealed here. Therefore, this chapter, every chapter in Bhagavad Gita is called as a yoga. And whatever is the central theme of that particular chapter is the name given to that yoga. Like, you know, Arjuna Vishada Yoga, Sankhya Yoga, Karma Yoga. So this is the topic which is the Sangati, which is the content of this topic. Now we go to the second chapter. The second chapter is called as Sankhya Yoga. I'm not going to tell you now what is the meaning of Sankhya Yoga because Arjuna Vishada is still continuing. And when we come to the teaching verse, actually teaching verse of Krishna in the 11th verse, there I'm going to tell you the meaning of what is Sankhya and why this particular chapter is called as Sankhya Yoga. At present, what is happening? Arjuna has suddenly come face to face with the changes of his life and he's trying to adjust. That's what we do. When we suddenly find ourselves in a miserable situation or a difficult situation, what do? We try our best to adjust the surroundings so that, you know, we are comfortable. And a stage comes when I can no longer do any kind of an adjustment and I'm not able to think clearly and what action I have to take, I'm not able to think about it clearly. And any action that I take is likely to be the wrong action. Therefore, I don't know what I should do, what I should not do, what is right, what is wrong. Next comes the stage of helplessness. So initially the samsara is felt and I try my best to manage it myself. then the second stage of helplessness. I can no longer manage it. No, I'm not able to. I can't see any light at the end of the tunnel. I need somebody to help me. I'm helpless. This helplessness is called as Karpanya. Karpanya is helplessness, which is going to be talked about Arjuna by himself. This is the Karpanya helplessness. When Karpanya is there, that I'm helpless now, I cannot do anything, I give up. At that time, the third stage is Sharanagati, or depending on a higher intelligence. There is something more than me. There is a higher intelligence from which I can take help. So there is a approaching and Sharanagati to a higher intelligence. That is the third stage. And fourth stage is what? When I approach and when I surrender Sharanagati to the higher intelligence, whatever it is, it may be God, it may be Guru, it may be Shastra, any higher intelligence, then what do? I pursue the advice given by whoever I have gone into surrender. So these are the four stages of all of us dealing with our samsara. Now, Arjuna has dealt with his samsara, tried to present his case, and he made a decision, I'm not going to fight the war and I'm going to give up my fight. Now, that is his decision, adjusting the circumstances. Now, he understands that this also is not really the answer for his confusion. And now, in this, the first few verses, Arjuna realizes his helplessness and surrenders to Lord Krishna, who has been his friend all these years and now his Sarathi. But he knows that Krishna is not a mere friend, not a mere Sarathi, but he is something higher. He is Ishvara Swarupa. That much knowledge Arjuna has. And then he surrenders to him and follows the pursuit that is advised by Krishna from the 11th verse of this chapter, where the actual teaching begins. Now, in the first verse, Sanjaya is continuing his reporting to Dhritarashtra. The previous verse also was that Sanjaya reported to Dhritarashtra that this Arjuna, who is a picture, a pathetic picture of samsara, has kept aside his astras and shastras, and he is sitting down on the floor of the chariot, completely desperate, in desperation. And he continues that in the second chapter. Sanjaya uvacha tam tatha kripaya vishtam ashrupurna kulekshanam vishidantam idam vakyam uvacha madhusudanaha. Now, for the first time, Krishna sees the need to talk something. So Sanjaya is telling tam tatha kripaya avishtaha. That kripa, that compassion which we talked about in the first chapter also, Arjuna, full of compassion, and here kripaya, kripa also means samsara, not just compassion. A compassion born out of severe samsara, a severe raga and shoka, is not the compassion in its purest form. It is an actually mixed up compassion in the wrong place and the wrong time. And how is he looking? Ashru purna akula ikshanam. Okay, what is he? Ashru purna akula ikshanam. Ashru purna akule ikshanam means, now his eyes, ikshanam, they are akula. They are blurred. They are not able to see clearly. There is a blurring of his eyes. He is not able to clearly see. Why? Because his eyes are filled with ashru. Ashru, tears. Just imagine such a valorous person like Arjuna, who is just waiting for this Dharma Yuddha. I don't think Krishna would have ever seen Arjuna like this, talking like this, crying like this, a picture of sorrow, despondency, and a person of severe diffidence. I don't think Krishna has ever seen him like this. And Vishidantam Arjunam, for this Arjuna towards Arjuna, he to the grieving Arjuna, Uvacha Madhusudana. Madhusudana or Bhagavan addressed Arjuna. Madhusudana means the one who has slain an asura called Madhu. Okay, Madhu asura, asuran sudayati iti parisudana. Madhu prabhritaya asuran sudayati iti Madhusudana. We have to understand here the Madhu has another meaning. Madhu also means ahankara. You see, an asura has an ahankara. That's why ahankara is compared to an asura. Madhu also means ahankara. And Krishna or Lord, through his teaching, destroys the ahankara and makes me see who I am actually. Otherwise, I'm all the time thinking I'm that ahankara. But it is Krishna who destroys the Madhu, ahankara, ahankarasya sudana iti Madhusudana, or asuran, asuran sudayati iti Madhusudana. Now Madhusudana said, and here first time Bhagavan says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Now Bhagavan also has a meaning. Now this meaning of Bhagavan also I'm going to give you when we start the 11th verse of this chapter where the teaching begins. Now Bhagavan Krishna is talking to Arjuna as a motivator. He has not yet started the teaching. How can any teaching happen in such a state of mind? Krishna also knows that. So first, he wants to literally whip Arjuna into action. Get up. You are sitting here. Get up. He has a totra vetra ekapanaye, Krishna. Totra vetra ekapani. He's holding that whip in one hand to literally make the horses start running. And in the same way, symbolically, now, by his words, he's going to whip Arjuna into action. And Krishna does not spare Arjuna with very, very, don't bother. I can understand what is happening to you. Please take care. Nothing will happen. Go ahead. No, no, no. He's not going to talk like that because Arjuna needs a very different kind of a motivation. And Krishna is using very, very harsh words. And Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupasthitam anaryajushtam asvargyam akirtikaram Arjuna. Now, Krishna is irritated, angry, and he says, Kutastva kashmalamidam. Hey Arjuna, from where has this come? Kashmalam, here. What is kashmalam? This vyakulam, this sorrow, this kind of a diffidence, this despondency. I have been with you for so many years. I have seen you fighting so many wars. I have never seen you with this kind of, which is, you know, not befitting a person like you. From where has it come, Arjuna? Kutastva kashmalamidam. From where has this come? How is it that you are getting it from? Where is this? I have never seen aspect of this kind of a thing. Vishame samurpastitam. And that too at a wrong place. Ayogya samaye. Vishame samaye means yogya samaye. If you have this talk, it is accepted. When we were in the forest for 13 years, when you and I used to chat every day, if you had talked to me about all these things at that time, before starting the war, before even thinking of the war, I would have accepted it. Yes, that is a yogya samaya. Now when both the parties are ready, and when you have accepted that this is Dharma Yuddha and it is your duty as a Kshatriya, this is an Ayogya Samaya. Ayogya Samaye, it is not the Yogya Samaya. And in Ayogya Paristhiti, this is not the right locus, right place also. Ayogya Samaye and also in the Ayogya, you know, wherever that place is, this is not something which you should do. So Vishame, that is in this Ayogya Samaye, Ayogya Kale, Samupastitam, it has appeared. It should not have appeared, now it has appeared. And it is nothing but Anarya Jushtam, Asvargyam, Akirtikaram, he Arjuna. This kind of a Kalmasham or this kind of, you know, Vyakulam that you are feeling, which has come at a wrong place and a wrong time, it is anarya jushtam, अनार्य जुष्ट मित्र, आर्या मीन्स एक्चुअली पर्सन ऑफ नोबल बर्थ, बट हियर एन आर्या, ही इज एड्रेसिंग अर्जुना एज अ यू आर एन आर्या, यू आर नॉट ओनली फ्रॉम ए नोबल बर्थ बट यू आर ए पर्सन हु नोज वॉट इज टू बी डन एट वॉट टाइम. दैट इज वाई देर इज अ डेफिनेशन गिवन फॉर आर्या. कर्तव्यम आचरण कर्म, अकर्तव्यम अनाचरण तिष्ठति प्रकृत आचारे. दैट मीन्स हु इज एन आर्या, कर्तव्यम आचरण कर्म. ओके, कर्तव्यम कर्मम आचरयति, आचरति, कर्तव्यम कर्मम आचरति, अकर्तव्यम अनाचरण, दैट विच इज नॉट टू बी डन ही डज नॉट डू एंड डज ऑल हिज व्यवहार, तिष्ठति प्रकृत आचारे. वॉट एवर इज द आचारा, आचारा, आचारा मीन्स वॉट इज टू बी डन, वॉट इज नॉट टू बी डन. द वन हु यूजेस हिज नोबिलिटी टू डू वॉट इज टू बी डन, वॉट इज नॉट टू बी डन. So a person who is an Arya need not be born always in a noble family. Any person who does the right thing at the right time and doesn't shirk his duty, where there is no dereliction of duty, he is an Arya. But what is Arjuna doing now? He is derelicting his duty that he is supposed to do. So it is anaryam for a person of anarya jushtam. And aswargyam. Aswargyam means adharmikam. Dharma leads to swarga. Correct? Aswargyam means this action is not going to get you any kind of a punya. It is a dharmikam action and it is a kirtikaram. Hey Arjuna, what is your kirti, remember? What are the various titles you have got? With all kinds of enemies you have fought. And for you, at this time, at this place, this kind of an attitude, it is not at all befitting you, Arjuna. Get up. So he's literally, flogging him or whipping him. And in the next verse, he still uses a very, very, acidic remark on Arjuna. Klaibhyam masmagamah partha naitatvatyupapadyate क्षुद्रम हृदय दौर्बल्यम त्यक्त्वा उत्तिष्ठ परंतप, त्यक्त्वोत्तिष्ठ परंप परंतप. हे परंतप, ही यूजेस द वर्ड परंतप. परंतप मीन्स द पर्सन हु स्कॉर्चेस हिज एनिमीज एंड द एनिमीज आर स्केर्ड ऑफ अर्जुना. असुराज आर स्केर्ड ऑफ अर्जुना, पीपल आर स्केर्ड ऑफ अर्जुना. सो यू आर द परंतप एंड उत्तिष्ठ. First you get up. Why? How? Why? You are behaving like Klaibhyam Masmagama Partha. You are behaving like a Klibaha. Klibaha means a eunuch or a Napumsaka. This is not the place that you have to behave like a Napumsaka. Klaibhyam. Okay. Klibaha means a Napumsaka. Klaibhyam means Klibasya Bhavaha. The one who has the attitude of a Klibaha. From where has this Klaibhyam come, Arjuna? You are almost behaving like a eunuch, not taking decisions, afraid. And it is this kind of an unmanliness I have never seen in you. From where has this come? And at this particular time. And not only that, na ye tat upapadyate. Na ye tat tvayi upapadyate. Na yetat, this tvayi in you, it cannot happen. It does not befit your status, hey Arjuna. And kshudram hridaya daurbalyam. And this low, mean, base kind of a daurbalyam, hridaya daurbalyam. You such a valorous person and you says, I don't want to fight, I'm afraid. And I'm sweating and my bow is slipping from my hands. And even if they kill me, it doesn't matter. It is better for me to get killed. What kind of an unmanliness is this, Arjuna, on this battlefield? Okay, tvayi, na yeta tvayi upapadyate, it does not befit you. And this kshudram, this base or the lowest of your hridaya daurbalyam, tyaktva, get rid of it. And uttishta parantapa, very harsh words he has used. Arjuna gets stung. Literally, by these words. And still he wants to tell Krishna that, no, no, I don't do you. I agree what you say, but it's not because I'm a Kleba or not because I have a Hridaya Daurbalyam, but these are my own people. I cannot kill. Again, he gives the same argument again. And he says to Arjuna, to Krishna, Arjuna uvacha katham bhishmamaham sankhye dronancha madhusudana ishubhi pratiyotsami pujarhavari sudana. Hey Krishna, these Bhishma and Drona, who are like the tata or who are like the banks of the Rananadi, which we saw last time, these are people who are puja arhaha. You know, whether they, you know, they consider, you know, me as their own child or their own, his own shisha or not, I don't know. Why they are suffering, you know, supporting the wrong side, I don't know. They may be having their own logic. Just because they are supporting Duryodhana and just because they are willing to fight with me, it does not mean that I don't respect them. I have a great respect for them. They are very venerable to me and they are worshipable to me. And for such a Bhishma and Drona, how will I kill them, Sankhye, in this war? And how will I hit back at them for their arrows? When they are shooting me with arrows, Ishubhihi, with my arrows, Katham Pratiyotsyami, how will I give back their arrows? How will I fight their arrows? Hey Madhusudana, hey Arisudana, you have destroyed demons, you have destroyed asuras, you have destroyed all these enemies of humanity. But remember, Krishna, they were not your swajanas. They were not your gurus. Bhishma is my grandfather. He is my guru. But Madhusudana, Arisudana, the ones you killed, they were not in any way related to you. They were the enemies of the entire society. But here, they may be standing in the enemy ranks, but they are still venerable to me. They are puja arhas to me. And he says that now the meter changes. There was this Anushtup Chandas earlier. Now we'll have a Trishtup Chandas. In Bhagavad Gita, whenever an important aspect has to be talked about, the Chandas changes. Vyasacharya sees that by changing the Chandas, or Chandas means the number of Varnas in each line. We won't go into the details of that. And here, there is a change in the Chandas. So the way it is chanted will also be different. Guru nahatva hi mahanubhavan shreyo bhoktum bhaiksham apihaloke hatvartha kamanstu guru nihaiva bhunjiya bhogandrudhira pradigdhan. So, hey Krishna, since they are puja arhas for me, guru nahatva hi mahanubhavan, these gurus, these Mahanubhavas, I am not going to kill, because it is much better to go away to the forest and live on bhiksha like a sannyasi. Because I know that if I don't kill these people, if I don't fight these people, then that army is going to completely massacre us and then there is no chance of my getting back this Raja. And I'll have to go back to the forest and live life of a mendicant. And I'm willing to do that. He says, though he is a Kshatriya, he's willing to live the life of a sannyasi or a vanaprasthi by asking for bhiksha. Bhaiksham means what? A collection of bhiksha is called as bhaiksham. Going to different houses and asking for bhavati bhikshandehi, and whatever everybody gives, you collect that, and that collection of bhiksha is called as bhiksham. What we call as madhukari vritti. It is called as a madhukari vritti, where you go to different people and collect and whatever they give. And there are number of how many people you should go and ask. That is also determined in Dharma Shastra. And whatever you get, you enjoy that. So he says, hatva artha kamans to guru nihaiva bhunjiya bhogan rudhira pradigdan. Even though my gurus are going to fight this war for Arthakama, they may be, I do not know. Why they are supporting adharma and fighting, I do not know. Whatever logic they may have, I am not interested. But I don't want to kill them, and I am willing to go back to the forest and live a life of a mendicant, asking for bhiksha and living on alms, because these bhogas, this raja which I will get will be Rudhira Pradhigdan. It will be tainted, it will be smeared with the blood of my gurus. Therefore, I do not want to do that. And in the next verse, the same thing he says. Na chaitad vidmakatarano gariyo yadva jaye maya divano jayeyuhu yane vahatva na jiji vishamaha tevastita pramuke dhartarashtra. He says, now I do not know whether we are going to win or not. That itself is not sure, Krishna. We are going to fight the war, yes. And all those, you know, puja arha people are on the other side. So I don't know whether I'm going to win the war or not. And what is it that is better for me? Yadva jayema yadivano jayeyuhu kataran gariyaha. I do not know whether I'm going to win or whether I'm going to lose. What are the chances of my winning? But yanyeva hatva na jijivishamaha. Killing these people, I will not be able to be alive, because that guilt of adharma, even our Duryodhana's adharma probably is tolerable, but killing my own gurus and my father, grandfather, people on in that particular, you know, status, who are standing in front of me, pramukhe dartharashtrayaha, who are avasthita. They, Bhishma, Drona, etc., my gurus are standing in front of me in the enemy lines. And in such case, hatva, yaneva hatva, I am not even going to, you know, be capable of living this life. And in the next verse, actually, Arjuna says, I am helpless, I surrender to you. So, the helpless samsari Krishna, in the next verse, in the seventh verse, becomes a shishya Arjuna. Sorry, I said Krishna. A samsari Arjuna becomes a shishya Arjuna and surrenders himself to Krishna. And this is the point of change where Arjuna becomes the shishya and Krishna becomes the guru. So he says, Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah prachami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaha yachreyasyanishchitam bruhitanme shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam. So he says that karpanya dosha, I'm suffering from helplessness. And what has this helplessness done? Apahata svabhava. My mind is completely seized by this helplessness, karpanya dosha. And hey Krishna, prachami tvam, I ask you, dharma samudha cheta, I am completely confused about dharma adharma, because this karpanya has completely apahata, it has kidnapped my intellect, and I am not able to see what is dharma from adharma. So, hey Krishna, I surrender to you, prapannam mam, yat shreyam syat nishchitam bruhi. Tell me Krishna, now I'm not going to run away from the battlefield. I'm not going to say that I'm not going to fight. I'm waiting for you. Tell me what is good for me. Yat shreyaha syat, whatever is shreya for me, what is the right thing for me to do? Nishchitam bruhi. Tell me very, very clearly. Tanme shishyaha teham, you are going to surrender to you as the shishya. Shadhi mam, instruct me. Shadhi means educate or instruct. Mam tvam prapannam, whom? The one prapannam, I have surrendered to you. To this me who has surrendered to you, please tell me very clearly. I cannot think anymore. Please tell me what I am supposed to do. And With this, Arjuna turns into a shishya. Nahi prapashyami mamapanudyat yachokamuchochanam indriyanam avapya bhumavasapatnamriddham rajam suranam apichadhipatyam. Now he's saying that whatever you tell me, I will do, Krishna. Nahi prapashyami mama apanudyat yat shokam uchoshanam indriyanam. He knows, Arjuna knows, that his grief is so intense that his mind and his indriyas are not able to function and think correctly. Hey Krishna, this grief has dried up all my indriyas. It has, you know, taken away all my capacity to think correctly and make a decision. And I may win this entire Raja. I may win even the three lokas. You know, the prospects are there. It is there. I may have a bhumau, avasapatna, a sapatna, mriddham rajam. I may win this rajam or even the entire mahi, entire earth, where I may be an unrivaled, prosperous king of an unrivaled, prosperous kingdom. I may even get the adhipatyam of even the gods, devas and suras. But I am not really bothered now. What is going to happen? Now, whether I am going to win or not, what I should do, I do not know. I may lose or I may even get the adhipatyam. I may be a chakravarti of this entire loka also. It doesn't matter. But you have to tell me what I have to do now. So, asapatnam riddham means asapatnam, without any kind of a rival king or kingdom. I may have this rajam, I may not have this rajam, I do not know. The only thing I know is that my grief and my sorrow has made me helpless. Now I surrender to you, Krishna. Please tell me what I have to do. Here, Arjuna is a mature, confused person. And Vedanta or Atmajnana that Krishna is going to teach is going to work for a mature, confused person. That is why Krishna chooses to teach Atmajnana, which is the content of the entire Upanishad. For an immature, confused person, Vedanta is not the answer. Then there are other things which the Guru will have to tell him. Right now, first, let there be some maturity in you and do this, 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 this. And once you are prepared for this, I will give you this jnana. But now, here is a mature, confused shishya in the form of Arjuna. And the Guru who has come for this purpose, for this avatara, who's waiting to give this knowledge, but was only waiting for Arjuna to surrender and ask for this knowledge. Because without asking for this by the shishya, the Guru does not give this knowledge unless it is asked. It should be asked and it should be given. So with this, actually, Krishna's role as a teacher and Arjuna's role as a student, here Krishna is the Guru for all of us. And we represent Arjuna. The context may be that of the war for Arjuna because he was a Kshatriya. But for us, the context may be our own samsara, in the way we face samsara. And the last verse, before we go, Sanjaya reported this to Dhritarashtra and said, Yeva muktva rishikesham guda keshav parantapa nayotsya iti govindam उक्त्वा तूष्णे बभूवतः तमुवाच ऋषिकेशः प्रहसन्निव भारत सेनयोरुभयोर् मध्ये विशीदन्तमिदं वचः. After saying this, Arjuna is silent. All his catharsis is over. Now Krishna is also silent. He is also now waiting to start his teaching. So in this period of silence, Sanjaya reports that in this way, Arjuna has become very quiet, waiting for Krishna, and Krishna with a smile on his face, Prahasanniva Senayor Ubhayor Madhye Vishidantam Arjunam Idam Vachaha. Krishna with his usual smile now is addressing Arjuna in this battlefield as a teacher. So from the next class, the actual teaching of Bhagavad Gita starts. And I may not be able to go so fast next time, because the first chapter and the first 10 verses of the second chapter were the background. And from here, the actual Atma Vidya starts, which is the purport of Bhagavad Gita. And here onwards, I'll have to go a little slower. Nandantu sadhaka sarve vinashyantu vidushakaha अवस्था शांभवी मेस्तु प्रसन्नोस्तु गुरु सदा सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखम् आप्नुयात् ओम शांति 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 ही ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।